In Drupal 7, when you'd hover over blocks, you can see this gear icon, and you can click it in order to adjust the block, or if the block is associated with a menu, you can also edit the menu. On the home page in Drupal 7, there's just a couple of blocks, and that's all we can hover over. In Drupal 8, however, you can hover over virtually anything and see this edit icon. And we can see all of the edit icons at once by clicking this edit link in the upper right-hand corner. There are some really important changes here. We'll start at the top and work our way down. First, the My Account logout links here can now be configured as a block. In Drupal 7, these menu items here were part of the theme. You could still add and remove items to the menu, and you could toggle it on and off, but you couldn't change its position on the page or adjust its display for different users. In Drupal 8, we can do that. The next thing that's a block in Drupal 8 that isn't in Drupal 7 is right here. This block contains the logo, the title, and the slogan on the site. In Drupal 7, these can be toggled on and off individually, but their display was set in the theme. So in order to adjust it, you had to override a template, which is not something that's super easy for beginners. The tabs here for the primary navigation are also a block, so you can change where they display and edit them in line here. Whereas in Drupal 7, this was also part of the theme and had to be adjusted through template overrides. The search and navigation blocks continue to be editable, although notice just a couple of minor changes. One is that the search block has a title, whereas in Drupal 7 it didn't. And also the magnifying glass icon drops to the second line. And also note that navigation has been retitled to tools, which makes a bit more sense because this doesn't help us navigate the entire site, just a particular section of it. So renaming it tools is a little bit more intuitive. Over here in the main content, we have two edit icons, and both of these are pretty exciting to me. The first is that this is the title of the page. It's now a block that can be toggled on and off, or you can change the position of it. In Drupal 7, you had to work pretty hard to get the title into a block so that you can adjust the display of it on different pages. And the second edit icon here indicates that the content here is actually a view. As you probably know by now, Drupal 8 comes with the Views module built in, and Views is used to display any list of content. In contrast, the home page in Drupal 7 was built from a series of core templates that you would have to override, or most likely, you would install Views and use Views to create an alternative aggregation of the content on your site. Views has an RSS feed enabled by default, which is why we see this little RSS feed icon. Now, the implication of Views being enabled for the front page content is that now we can modify nearly every aspect of how it displays. We can change what content we display on the home page. We can change the order of fields and the output of each piece of content however we'd like to, and we can do it all through the interface. So that's pretty awesome. Down here, we have two more edit icons. In this one, we have a block for a menu, which isn't surprising, but the link here, contact, is something that doesn't show up in Drupal 7. And that's because the contact module is now enabled by default in Drupal 8, and it's also undergone a major overhaul to be a bit more like the contributed web form module in Drupal 7. And just like in Drupal 7, we can edit the block powered by Drupal.